Hello, this is Josh from Palo Alto Networks, and I am going to give you a quick walkthrough on how to use the download packs and images script that's part of the Demisto SDK GitHub repo to pull down content packs and Docker images for use in an air-gapped or offline installation of XSOAR. The script is fairly simplistic and can be downloaded from the GitHub repo, as I mentioned before. This is just the sample script and the URL, which I will post in the comments of this video. And to use the script, what you're going to do is you're going to create a file. In this case, I called it packs.txt, but you can call it whatever you want. And what this is going to be the name of the content pack that you're looking to download from the XSOAR marketplace. So if I head over to the marketplace, I'm literally going to take the name as it's shown here in the on the web page and paste that into a text file. Now, this can be one file, it could be one content pack, it could be as many as you want. Just make sure you copy the name exactly as it's displayed on the Cortex Marketplace online. What I'm going to then do is I am going to run the download packs and Docker images Python script and pass it the packs.txt as a parameter for the dash p option. So I'm going to go ahead and run that. And while that's downloading, one thing that's important to note is you have to have Docker Desktop installed and operational on your Windows workstation if you're doing this on a Windows machine. If you're on Linux, you need to make sure that Docker CE is installed. And now once this is complete, we're going to have two files that have been created, a docker.zip and a packs.zip. And we can see the docker.zip is about 157 megabytes, while packs.zip is 213K. Docker.zip will get uploaded to the XSOAR server, while packs.zip will remain on your local machine because you're going to upload that through the XSOAR UI. I've already got a copy of these files on my XSOAR server, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to switch over to the Demisto user. And I'm going to change to the home directory. And you can see docker.zip is already present. So what you want to do from this location is unzip the docker.zip file. And you're going to see a bunch of tarball files. And then the next thing to do is there's a little bash script that I wrote to iterate over each of the tar files and do an import into XSOAR. It's important to note that you want to stop the Demisto service. Obviously, you would do this as root, not as the Demisto user, which I'm currently logged into, before running this import. And then the script looks like this. So it's going to iterate over every tar file, and it's going to call podman load. And it's going to specify the local directory of ./tmp. This was done for a STIGD installation of XSOAR, but if you don't have any restrictions on where file or commands can be executed, you don't need that parameter, the --tmpdir. Additionally, it has you press enter between tar files just to prevent timeout of the session because some of these get pretty large. The machine learning image, I think, is about a gig and a half in size, so it could result in an SSH timeout depending on how your system's configured. Now, I'm not going to run this right now because I've already imported all these files. But as you can see, this is the associated containers that are needed to run the different content packs from the XSOAR marketplace, and these are the packs themselves. Now, to upload the packs, you can take that zip file and navigate to the marketplace in the XSOAR UI and click the little three-dot drop-down here and click Upload Content Pack. And what you'll do then is navigate to where that packs.zip file is stored and select it, and it'll upload all of that content directly into XSOAR. Once you've uploaded the docker.zip and installed all those tarball files using podman, you want to make sure you restart the Demisto service. And another note for packs.zip, it might take a minute for the content packs to install, so you'll see a little spinning icon up here. Once that's done, you'll get a little notification at the bottom of the screen that the packs have been installed successfully. And that's how you go about downloading the Docker images and content packs for use in an air-gapped or offline installation. I hope this helps, and please let me know if there's any other content you'd like to see. Thank you.